Australian gold and copper this afternoon is Glen Diemar. Glen, good afternoon.
G'day, everyone.
Look, Andrew. This is a significant update that you put out yesterday. You've identified a large magnetic body underneath the Boxdale-Carlisle gold trend. The announcement itself, slightly on the technical side, just break it down for us, outline the significance.
Nothing like a magnetic body to get people excited. We always knew this big magnetic trend was underneath Boxdale and Carlisle, the 15-kilometre Boxdale-Carlisle trend. And we've been talking about that for quite a while, and it's on exactly the same strike as the gold trend. We were thinking, well, it's probably about time that we work this thing out a bit better. And so we had our geophysicist model it in three dimensions, which is quite a process. And we also wanted to work out how deep it was, Andrew. So we don't think it's not what we're shooting for, but we want to understand the architecture of the whole system. And we know this magnetic body called the ultramafic does outcrop about 10 kilometers to the south. And I've got photos of it outcropping in that announcement. They're our drone photos. And it's a gabbro, an ultramafic. And it's in the same complex as some really quite fertile ultramafics in the area. So Cleantech, their Sunrise deposit, or they're now called Sunrise, but it's one of the largest nickel, cobalt, scandium, and PGE laterite deposits in the world. It's very big, and it's just 15 kilometers north of us, and it sits in one of these. Ours is a bit deeper. So our question was, well, how is this affecting the gold mineralization above? And we wanted to model it, see how deep it was, and see how it can play out and help us explore this for this gold trend.
Well, now that this has been identified, how might this impact the strategy moving forward for you?
We wanted to understand the bigger picture, because 15 kilometers is a long way, and this is also along a large fault called the Boobaroy Fault, which comes from Lake Cowal. So Lake Cowal's the 11 million ounce gold mine, which is mined by Evolution, along a big fault that comes right up and into this zone. And it looks like this ultramafic is sort of sitting on that fault or come up because of that fault. And it's not going to help us move a drill hole 50 meters here or there, but it's going to help us understand. Geologists like to think big and think about scale. So you know, we put out some drill hole announcements about a month ago, and we got some quite good results, and that was from our first pass drilling at Boxdale. And we've now drilled 5,000 metres since December, and we're currently waiting on two of the program's results, so from Carlisle Reefs and our second phase at Boxdale. So we're waiting on about 3,440, actually, exactly, drill results. So we've still got lots of gold assays coming. But this announcement yesterday just really helps us understand the big picture always the question, should we stay or go? And I think this shows there's been a lot of fluid movement, and the gold is potentially coming from a big red blob underneath the earth, which is always nice to tie in.
Potentially, would you broaden your search beyond gold and copper?
Tricky question. Good question. Yes, obviously we would. We are looking at the potential for PGEs in there as well. So we don't hold where the body outcrops. We don't hold that piece of ground, but we're not too worried about that, because we think our sediments over the top have trapped the gold, and we're exploring that option as well.
So in terms of near-term news, near-term activity, Glen, what's happening on the ground, and what can we expect to hear from you?
Great. I invite all investors and shareholders to the RIU conference next week in Sydney, the RIU Resources Roundup. And it's always a good one, and it's a big one this year. Lots of companies going to be there. I'm presenting on the Tuesday, so I'm keen to see some familiar faces in the crowd. And so we'll be getting that corporate presentation out. And the 3,440 assays that are coming out shortly, or in batches, though. That'll be coming soon. We're hoping next week as well. And then the next phase of exploration here, and also at Cargilligo, and also Gundagai, the big gold project that we've got there for maiden drilling. That maiden drilling got pushed back because of our good announcements here at Boxdale and Carlisle Reefs. So we wanted to focus on this. So it's working pretty well, our focus on the gold story at the moment.
Certainly plenty planned, Glen. Good to catch up. Thanks very much.
Thanks, Andrew. Always nice.